Hi, I'm Asad Islam, the Epi Info team lead at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. And today I'll be showing you how easy it is to quickly start using Epi Info 7. Epi Info 7 is available for download in two different formats. It's available as a compressed zip file. It's also available as a traditional setup or installation file. We made two different formats to give our users some flexibility. For example, say you're out in the field responding to an outbreak. You need to collect and analyze data quickly, but you don't have admin rights on your machine. Well, you can still use Epi Info 7, and this is how. Just download the Epi Info 7 zip file. Instead of saving the file, just click open. If Microsoft Windows opens it using a standard window, just select all the contents and drag and drop them onto your desktop. Now, if the zip file had opened using a third-party product such as WinZip, then just select the extract option from that tool and have it extract to your desktop or any other folder where you have read-write access. Now, all I have to do is double-click the Launch Epi Info 7 icon and start using Epi Info 7. That's it. It was really that simple. There is also a setup file available for those that need to install software the traditional way. If you are in a private network where your network admin installs software for you, then this is your preferred option. Just ask your admin to download the setup file and install it onto your machine, adhering to the policies of your particular network environment. This method of installation also requires elevated privileges on your machine. Now, since I'm not an admin and I don't have elevated privileges, I will just cancel out of this window. So let's go back to the Epi Info window on my desktop. As I mentioned earlier, Epi Info 7 is ready to be used. So let's start by creating our first data entry form. I will click the Create Forms button and load the form designer. Then I click New Project and specify the project name and the name of the first form in this project. Once Epi Info gives me a blank canvas to work with, I can either drag and drop individual fields. Let's call this one Patient ID, or an entire template. If you're wondering how these templates get created in the first place, well, that's coming in another video. When I'm done creating the form, I can start data collection right away. So I click on Enter Data, keep the default settings, and start entering data into my database.